My name is Scotty Ducharme. I'm originally from International Falls in Fort Frances, Ontario. I first became interested in law when I was 10 years old and my parents separated, and there was kind of an ensuing number of sort of legal processes that basically resulted in my father losing the majority of his parental rights. My siblings and I gave evidence through various means. We were represented by an attorney named Dave Kudick, who worked for Legal Aid, and he did a really good job. And so that was kind of the first moment where I thought, I want to do that. One of the things that made me interested in Mitchell Hamlin was the alumni base. I wanted to stay as close to where I grew up as possible because I felt like I had a real connection to the people who I grew up with, and they're the people who I wanted to go back and work with as an attorney. There's a huge base of alumni here in the metro area, but there's even a bigger saturation once you get to the rural areas of Minnesota, where I'm from. That was a big draw to me. The people who I knew in the community graduated from here, and I could go here and go back and be part of that alumni community. I toured, you know, numerous schools, and I would say that no school had a better reception for an entering student than Mitchell Hamlin. I remember particularly meeting Raleigh Levine, and she had specific questions about my personal statement in a very sort of natural and conversational way. And so it's like, wow, these people have read my submission materials. Numerous people who I've talked to know stuff about me. And so that was a big difference. One thing that I think every prospective student should know, because this was a big concern for me when I was looking at law schools, is if you choose a school, will you be able to have genuine opportunities to interact and work with faculty and genuine opportunities to work in the courts? And both of those things have been kind of the hallmarks of my experience at Mitchell Hamlin. You will get to know your professors on a personal basis. You will work closely with them on real legal projects with real legal clients. A lot of my courtroom experience at Mitchell Hamlin came through my working relationship with Joanna Woolman, who is the director of the Institute to Transform Child Protection. I joined the clinic. I worked with a number of clients who had active child protection cases. One of my cases in particular, we went to trial, and I was able to conduct trial in that case. After the close of trial, we had some appealable issues, and we went on to the Court of Appeals, and I argued at the Court of Appeals. I mean, there is no substitute for the real thing. Having a real client with real consequences on the line and going before a real tribunal and arguing on their behalf. But I felt fully supported throughout the process. Not only did I have the support of the clinic faculty, Joanna Woolman and Natalie Netzel, but other professors came on board. Okay, so I've got an evidentiary question, you bug an evidence professor. I've got a procedure question, you bug your procedure professor, and they are more than willing to help you out on that issue. One of the things I'm sure any student is concerned about is, what are your job prospects going to be, you know, during law school and most importantly, after law school? After my second summer, I was able to get a job with the Honorable Dale Harris, who was one of the judges who I regularly appeared in front of. Part of being able to get that job was all of the support I got from the attorneys who I was working with. You know, it should be no surprise that Judge Harris is an alum of the school, as well as my supervisor at the public defender. And so there's commonality as far as, you know, we all went to the same school. We all had Ed Butterfoss for contracts. And so that, you know, that's really something you have in common. You know, it's been a long journey from being 10 years old and having that first idea to here, but that kind of inspiration is what stuck with me the entire time.